those must be the two scariest words in the English language.
What?
Sailing weekend. Let's go on a sailing weekend. In actual fact, I think I'd rather go on a having your nose pulled off weekend or a sitting in sick weekend. Don't go.
I have to.
Why?
I've already bought one of those shiny yellow hats that sailing people wear.
What is the point of sailing? Silly little wobbly boats with silly wobbly people on them.
There's nothing silly or wobbly about me and Deborah.
Well, I don't know where you got that idea from. I think there's only one thing more pointless than sailing.
Asking you to shut your face.
No. No, flying a kite. Right? You stand in a wind, you get some dreary slave to run along with it, it flaps about a bit, it pops to the ground, you spend an hour winding up the string, and then you go home. No, I'll tell you what, in fact, I'll tell a lie. There is a more pointless thing. Puppet shows. Staging your own puppet shows and doing the voices of the little characters while wiggling them around.
You really are an incredibly joyless character, aren't you?
No, not me. I'm built for fun.
Really?
Yeah.
All my friends think you're built for pointing at and slapping.
Come to my bedroom and make love.
Why? Who's in there?
With me.
I can't. Deborah's coming down in a minute.
Well, she'll understand. She knows people have to have sex.
She doesn't. She has no idea.
Oh. What am I supposed to do for sex this weekend?
Well, I don't need to draw you a picture. Look, you know how cramped you felt when I was living here? You kept going on about needing more quality bloke time, more lager space.
That was last week. I'm changeable. That's why I'm so fascinating.
No, it's good that we do our own thing. What's tragic is that your thing seems to be watching TV, drinking beer, and talking to Tony in your unusual homemade grunting language.
Look, brilliant, isn't it?
You'll have to help us out with what it is.
No, this is good. I'm doing the garden up for us. This is one of me stools for me wooden seating area, and there's going to be a wooden barbecue and a little wooden wheelbarrow with a little wooden wheel.
So wood, very much the theme then, Tony.
Yep. Yeah, and I'm going to convert the shed into a sauna.
A sauna, really?
What do you mean?
So you won't be begging and pleading Deborah to hop into your converted shed with you wearing nothing but a little tiny towel, then?
Thought never even entered my head. Show you me plans before you go away.
What sort of plans?
Yeah, come look. Yeah. Now, you see, there'll be a seating area here with stools, and there'll be a barbecue here, you see, for Barbies. Here, toss me over one of those pork chop guys, will you, Cobber? And another tinny from me tucker bag. And if there's any wood left over, I'm going to make a wishing well.
Don't, Tony.
Oh, OK.
Why have you drawn people lying down in the shed?
Yeah. Right, now, that, I think, is now a sauna.
A sauna?
It's a Swedish thing.
I know. Where's the shed going?
No, you see, I'm converting the shed into a sauna. I suppose, technically, it'll be called a shedna.
To all the things that are in the shed?
Yeah, anyway, I hope to have it completed over the weekend so that when you get back from your sailing weekend, we can, you know, just pop straight into the sauna. Apparently, you go in all tense and you come out all floppy.
So I've heard.
And it's really healthy. They say after half an hour in the sauna, you can see the dirt oozing out of you.
So it's a bit like sitting in the shed.
Excellent.
Tony, I might argue if I really thought for one minute you would actually do it.
No, no, I am actually serious. I've even chosen the towels, look.
Bit on the small side, aren't they?
No, no, I checked in Sauna magazine. These are pretty standard.
Can you honestly imagine me wearing that?
Very much so. Bring that straight now.
Yeah. So you reckon the old sauna's the answer with Deborah then?
Yeah, yeah. She once told me that the heat makes her feel sexy.
And you reckon she'll still feel sexy lying basically in a warm shed?
No, no. I'll kit it out like a proper sauna. You know, pictures of Scandinavians.
Well, like ABBA.
Yeah, yeah. That'd be good.
Or a photo of an open sandwich. That's very Scandinavian.
Yeah. Hey, you know how ABBA is made up of their initials?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I've been thinking, right. What if Agnetha or Anifred had been called, say, Betty? Then ABBA would have been known as Bab.
Yeah.
And if Benny had been called Sven, ABBA would have been called Saab. And if they'd teamed up with the Bee Gees, Barry, Robin and Morris, then they could have called themselves Brabham.
What are you girls doing?
Water skiing.
Water skiing? Where's your skis?
Some girls.
Hi.
Hi. Hi.
Nice washing.
Nice. Yeah. You ever been scuba diving?
Sorry, mate.
It's okay. So where'd you get your shorts? My mum's got some just like them.
Which of us are you asking?
Either.
I thought you said your mum had some just like them. They can't be like both of them.
Yeah.
Would you like to come to a barbecue tonight?
He'll be there.
Thinking. We better allocate birds. We can't just steam in there mob-handed. We've got to treat these girls with the respect they deserve as two separate chicks.
Yeah.
And I think Paula is the one for me.
Why?
Well, I don't know. It could be... could be a smile.
Smile, yeah.
It could be that little tinkle in a laugh.
Little tinkle, yeah.
But I think it's probably because she's obviously begging for it.
Oh, thanks. So while you're off playing Who's Bush with your sexy piece, I get to chat to a librarian friend about what the weather's been doing.
Yeah, yeah. I'm a single bloke and you've got Dorothy.
Well, who knows what she's up to? It was a handful of your horn. Oh. I mean, it wouldn't be the first time one of us has gone away for the weekend and she's ended up... Oh. Shinning up some bloke's mast and hoisting his giblet or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was with you.
Yeah, sorry. I'm sorry. You know what it's like. I mean, you're sitting on a sofa with a girl, next minute your tongue's...
Ah! Sorry. It's OK.
All right, then, you have Paula. Quite fancy Carol, anyway. And they say it's always the quiet ones.
No, I'm having Carol.
Okay.
Oh, I've had a great day building stuff.
Hey, do you know, I always wanted to be a carpenter. I don't mean in the group, the carpenters. So.
Yeah, sure, mate.
Yeah. Do you know, I once built a treehouse in our garden, but we didn't have any trees, so I built it on the ground.
Probably safer, anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
I built a Wendy house when I was little. Obviously, I called it a Gary house. I used to eat all my meals in it. I didn't want to, but my parents insisted.
We did one book at school, you know, but I got chucked out for nailing Dave Tuffin to the workbench. If it wasn't for that, I'd probably be a carpenter now. And I don't mean in the group, the carpenters.
No, no. I don't know, mate. Aren't we supposed to blow on it or something? What's wrong?
Blowing it out. Maybe we should buy some sort of lighter fluid.
Evening.
Hey, you're the sausage.
Howdy.
You're pork chops.
Should I blow on it? It looks like it's going out.
Now, what we're doing, you see, is letting the flames build up really quite substantially to sear the juices in.
Sear them in? I reckon you'll scare the crap out of them.
Hi.
Hi.
Yeah, and what Tony's doing now is going round and nicely ensuring that the barbecue stays under control. Thank you, Tony. Tony, can I interest you in a beverage? What can I get for you?
Do you have anything other than lager?
Yep.
Lager.
Okay, so you've gone for the lager. Lovely choice. Well, allow me.
So, the burgers are on. Do you know, I think they're nearly done, actually.
So welcome, welcome. I must say, you're a great improvement on the last tenant. She's a squalid old tart.
That's my auntie, actually. She still lives there.
Oh, well, give my love when you see her.
We're staying down with her till tomorrow, having a crazy time in London, you know. I can be a bit of a wild child, me.
Oh, great.
What about you, Paula?
I've left my husband with the kids. It's great. I'd really like him.
Yeah. Carol, did you know that song?
Burgers, Tony.
Yeah.
Burgers. Cheers.
Oh, there's Jessica on the lawn. It's a bit out of focus, but she's really cute, isn't she?
Yeah.
You can see how she's grown.
Yeah, upwards.
If you just compare her with a few months back, should I go back?
Oh, no.
Oh, OK. Oh, there's Jessica and Hayley by the swing. And there's Jessica pushing Hayley on the swing. Mm. And there's Hayley pushing Jessica on the swing. Mm-hmm. Oh, and there's the swing. Hayley took that one. I don't mind being tickled.
No, nor do I.
It's like halfway between pleasure and panic, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's really sexy.
Mm.
Have you ever had an orgasm without being touched?
So how does that work? No, I need to be touched. Mm. Not always for very long. Do you want to go inside and, you know?
Yeah?
No,
okay.
Sure, I understand. You've got your own sense of right.
I said yes.
All right.
These ones. They're just going Hayley on the slide. Nice place.
Oh, you know, it keeps the rain off. Seat.
Thanks. What work do you do?
You know the wings on aeroplanes?
Yeah.
I make them.
What's going to be big in aeroplane design, then?
Oh, everything's going to be fatter and more pointy.
Uh-huh.
You're a lovely lady, Carol.
Gary, are you going out with anyone? Is it serious?
Oh, God, no. No, no, no.
Why are you going out together, then?
I don't want to talk about her. I want to talk about you. Your lips are like liver.
I think we should go to bed.
Right, yes. Bed. Bed it is, then. Let's do the old bed thing. Bed, bed, bed. Bed, 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 bed. Bed, 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 bed. Hang on a minute, why are you doing this? It's a joke, isn't it?
No.
So what's in it for you?
Women like sex too, you know, Gary.
Oh, do you?
You gonna phone Gary then?
Dunno. Oh, we've entered the lager zone. He might be able to tell me over and over how much he loves me.
Oh, well, at least he tells you. Mm. I've had boyfriends that have needed 9 pints to announce that they think they might be edging towards liking me.
Gary once phoned me from a pub and told me he loved me 32 times. I counted.
Aww.
He spoiled it slightly by turning up an hour later with a woman he picked up from the chip shop.
Loyal, though.
He is. He's lovely. But part of the problem is he doesn't know how to talk to women. He's got 2 chat-up lines. Hi, my name's Gary. Can I stand here? And hello, you smell brilliant.
I heard one of Tony's once. It was, hi, you must come from the planet Top Totty. I always think having a steady boyfriend is like owning your own flat. You spend ages making it look nice and then you realise
you
want to
move. Yeah. Sometimes, I don't know, I look over at Gary in bed and, oh, he looks so sleepy and gentle and his tongue's lolling and I think, I could have done a lot worse. And then I think, how exactly have I done a lot worse?
Then, Deborah says to me, no, you don't love me, you just want to sleep with me. And I said, that's nonsense. So she says, no, it's not nonsense. So I said, OK, you're right. Sex always gets in the way. So let's get it out of the way. By having it. Then it's been had. It's done. It's over with, forgotten, and it's out of the way. That was in 1992. And in the autumn of that year, right, I had quite long hair, by the way, in those days. People used to stop me in the street, ask if they could touch it. And I tried to snog her during an episode of Emmerdale Farm, which is what it was still called in them days. Mm. Dozed off. Oh. Friend was a bit tired, so I popped her back into your garden. That's all right. Had a nice chat. I'm jealous, Gary. I want to be with someone. Like you. In a bed. I'll tell Dorothy. Hello. Oh, hello, Dorothy.
Yeah, very quiet. We had a barbecue and there was just the two of us at it and nothing happened, and now we're all inside and nothing's still happening, very much so.
Tony, can I have a word with Gary, please?
Yeah, I'll just get him. Why do you want to talk to Gary? I know what he'd say. I can say it.
Well, I've just realised we've been going out for exactly 7 years. I was just feeling a bit sentimental.
Right. I'll tell him then. Bye.
Everything all right? Yeah. Except it sounds like Gary's either passed out or he's with a woman.
So that was rather jolly then.
Hmm.
I very much enjoyed it.
Me too.
Thank you very much. I've got this peculiar feeling. Can't explain it.
Guilt?
Remind me what that feels like again.
Well, I think you underestimated how strong your relationship with your girlfriend is.
Oh, no, no, no. Extraordinarily shaky, flimsy.
When we were making love, you said things like, Dorothy lifts her legs up for that bit. And Dorothy and I tend to save that till the end.
Yeah, but still...
And you might want to make a kind of mewing noise now. Dorothy usually does.
Was that a problem?
Well, it did make me feel like a bit of an impressionist.
Oh, sorry. Thanks for having a stab at the mewing anyway.
You're welcome.
I think it's more of a squeak, actually. No, no, it's a mew. No, it's a squeak. Or maybe it's a mew. I ought to record it, really, then I could have played it to you.
Gary, you're making it worse.
Worse? OK, I'll stop.
So, you don't do this very often?
It's not for the want of offers, I can tell you. If I had a quid for every time I've been propositioned...
How much?
£2.
Does that include me?
Does that include you? Yes, I think so.
What happened the other time?
Oh, she had to go downstairs and collect more fares or something.
So...
Don't go.
I have to.
Ah, you're right. Go now and leave it as something perfect.
No, I have to go, because we're off to Madame Tussauds.
Oh, well, that's a good reason, too. Oh. So, have you got everything?
Earrings, underwear, slight sense of awkwardness.
Well done.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
I did it, 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 I did it.
So that's that, then. Ships that pass in the night.
Yeah, but you didn't just pass in the night, did you? You were more like ships that got under the duvet and gave each other a good seeing to in the night. Did you see what I'm saying about ships?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She had this little mole.
You've got to pull yourself together, mate. You've committed adultery.
It happens.
Yeah, well, I suppose you had a bit of catching up to do, didn't you?
Yeah, yeah, I did.
I mean, you've only been to bed with three women, and that's very, very few.
Yeah, yeah, thank you, Tony.
Yeah, and since you've been together, Dorothy's been out with, loads of blokes.
Yeah, 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 shut up. Yeah. You see, I'm not a moral philosopher, as you know.
No.
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 Never have been, never likely to be, not full-time, anyway.
Full-time, no.
No. But I reckon it's all right to cheat on your loved one, if that person
is on a sailing weekend.
No, no, if the other person doesn't find out. I'm not exactly proud about what I've done, so keep it under your hat, eh?
Welcome home!
Thanks.
I'll finish the sauna.
Hello, girls.
You should have come with us.
Ah, you know, things to do.
Yeah, I had to clear the shed out and everything. Are you ready for your sauna? I've put some pictures of ABBA up inside.
I'll go and get ready.
Yeah, me too.
How was your weekend?
Mad.
What did you get up to?
You know, lads will be lads.
Gary, you seem to want to tell me something. I phoned last night. You weren't around.
Well, while the cat's away.
Stop it, Gary.
Okay.
So, what happened last night?
I passed out and Tony slept with the girl from next door.
Right. Well, I thought maybe you...
Well, me? Oh, God, no.
Great. OK. Right, well, I'm going to go upstairs now. If you'd like to join me, that'd be nice.
Right, I'll be up. Coming up.
Yes. Dun, dun, dun.
Sauna's allowed to have windows.
Yeah, oh yeah, yeah. We had a bit of a fire yesterday, so for safety, I'm using gas.
I'll fetch the broom.